So our next example, example 2, we are going to deal with this graph. Example 2. And this is a graph of the water in a reservoir over a 1 year period. X is the number of days since the beginning of the year, and W is the water in the reservoir. So what's happening here? Let's just talk about what's happening. So at x equals 0, we're right there. That's x equals 0. And our graph is up here at 50. So what does that mean? That means on the first day of the year, the reservoir was registering at a depth. And I'm not sure if that's feet or meters. I'm not sure. It doesn't say in the problem. So we'll just say that it's feet for right now. So at a depth of 50 feet. And it's slowly increasing over time until we hit 150 feet. So what is our max level here? What's our maximum amount of water that we hit? Well, it's at 150 days, but the max level we need to trace over and say that's, you know, roughly halfway between, maybe it's at 80, it looks like. So 80, maybe it's 80 feet. And what's our min level? So the minimum y value occurs, it appears down here somewhere. And that seems to be at maybe 20 or so, 20 feet. What else do we know that's happening? Well, we can describe some things about the actual real-life situation based on this. So at around 150 days into the year, our water level starts dropping. Well, what's happening 150 days into the year? That's about, you know, a little less than halfway. That's the beginning of summer. So we've got evaporation. We've got usage because of the summertime that we don't have in the winter. So that's what's really happening here, is that the water level is dropping due to that. And the increase right here, the sharper increase, might be, say, runoff from the snow melting and that kind of thing. So the reservoir levels go up and then they drop. And towards the end of the year, they start to climb again as water usage goes down. What else can we talk about this function? What else does the graph tell us? What's the domain of the function? Well, according to the piece we have right here, the domain goes from 0 to 350 days. And it's really important that we do actually cut it off at 350 days because in this case, or maybe the data we have only goes to 350 days. So we want to be real careful about how we state the domain, because if we don't have data for the last 15 days, then we can't say that's in the domain. And how about the range? Well, the range goes from 20 to 80, according to what we looked at for the minimum and the maximum level. So you see where we got that off the graph. We were looking from the smallest to largest x for the domain, and the smallest to largest y for the range.